the Crystal Palace dinosaurs.
In the 1800s, paleontology was a brand new science. Fossils were being discovered around the world, and they brought with them an extraordinary set of ideas that there were animals and plants, landscapes that had gone before and were no longer anywhere to be found on the planet. There was this idea of extinction. It's an abstract idea. It's hard to get your head around that, and it was one that didn't really get translated to the general public very well until Crystal Palace Park was built.
The park opened in 1854, and this was the first time that members of the public were able to see scientific ideas that before then had been hidden behind closed doors. And one can imagine someone coming into the park, having a walk, coming around the corner and seeing these two life-size iguanodons and thinking, what on earth is this? And wanted to know more about it and wanted to learn more about it. And that was the idea that the artist had, was to bring together entertainment and education into the same space so that people could see them and ask questions about them and learn more about the world in which they lived in.
The sculptures are grade one listed and have been recently put on the Heritage at Risk Register. They are officially classified actually as buildings. A number of them are hollow on the inside, and they are very big. In fact, in 1853, just as the park was being finished, they hosted a dinner inside one of the half-finished sculptures.
The artist who built these creatures was called Benjamin Waterhouse Hawkins. You can imagine the artist in his workshop working with the scientists of the day to make sure that these creatures were represented in the best way that they possibly could be according to the information that was available. And representing that for us today are these two iguanodons. So they look very different, but they're representing the same animal. And this was because science at that time didn't agree on how the animal would have stood. And the artist decided that actually, rather than decide which one was correct, he would just represent both. And for us, this is perfect because it shows the evolution of science and the way in which knowledge develops.
The sculptures aren't representative of how we might imagine dinosaurs and other extinct animals to look today. But in that is part of the story of science, and that's what makes this site so important and why it speaks to us still. There is no absolute truth out there through science, but it's an improved understanding and improved knowledge. And that's what makes the Crystal Palace dinosaurs relevant for today. The vivacity of the sculptures, it was down to the skill of Benjamin Waterhouse Hawkins, the artist. And that's what captured the public's imagination and what kept the site alive for the last 170 years.